water inlet and outlet, etc. This is the main switch to turn on or off the kit. This is the switch for the heater. Now we can see there are four valves for three outlet pipe. So this is V1, this is V2, this is V3, and this is V4. There are three outlet pipe. This and this blue one is for cold water, and this red one is for hot water. And here, this one is the water inlet pipe. Through this, we will give the cold water supply, and this is the release valve. Now we can see there is a pipe wrapped with white thread. So inside this pipe, there are two concentric tubes. The hot water flow through the inner tube, and the cold water flow through the outer tube. In parallel flow, the direction of the cold water is parallel to the direction of hot water, and in counter flow, the direction of cold water is opposite to the direction of hot water. So when this two liquid flowing through this pipe, the heat get exchanged between this two liquid. Now we will perform the experiment to find out the effectiveness of heat exchanger through parallel flow. Now first we will see the effectiveness of heat exchanger in parallel flow. For this we need to keep V1 open, V2 closed, V3 open and V4 closed. Now give the water supply. So we can see through here cold water is coming and through here hot water is coming, and through this cold water is coming out and through this hot water is coming out. Now we need to take the measurement that is given in the observation table. First we will need to take the temperature of hot water inlet that is given in the table here. So for the hot water inlet in the manual, you can see for the hot water inlet, keep this knob at T2, and this is the hot water inlet. T1 is for cold water inlet. T3 is for hot water outlet, and T4 is for cold water outlet. So in this table, fill up this measurement. Also take this measurement jar of 1 liter. This comes with the kit, and keep this here. Take a stopwatch and take the time to and measure the time it takes to fill up the jar. This will go for both hot water and cold water. Now with the help of this reading, we can do this calculation where we can get the effectiveness of heat exchangers. Similarly, for the counter flow, we need to first open the cold valve. So keep in mind, when we are changing from parallel to counter, first open all the four valves. Now we will need to close V1. We need to close V1 and V3. So this is counter flow. This is counter flow. In counter flow, cold water, the direction of cold water is opposite of the direction of hot water. Now similarly, take the reading with the help of the temperature indicator. Fill up the observation table, and with this we can calculate the heat effectiveness of counter flow.